Welcome back. Today we're well fading on the Pittsburgh line around Altoona area. We're well fading on the Carney's Crossing just like east of Lily, Pennsylvania. Our first train will be a coal train back towards Shire Oak, Pennsylvania with an N-2 trailing third, 2768. Here comes a second train of the day, basically. We have so many trains more to go, but here comes our first intermodal on the Pittsburgh line. I would say this would probably, we would see a lot more intermodal than I thought we would. I don't know. This would be our first one with an ACE leading and a C6M as a trailing unit. Anyway, I bet you can see, it is going slower much that I would thought we would not have a westbound, but you're just gonna have to wait and see. Thank you. Hey, what a random surprise. With another train. This one is a westbound intermodal bound for Chicago, Illinois, with a P5 as a horn on the leader. As soon as I thought we wouldn't have one, but here we go. This is the westbound. It's going by right now. Third train of the trip so far. We've only been at Kearney's Crossing for 30 minutes. We only got 2 trains, which is crazy. Alright, here comes our 4th train of the trip. This one will be a mixed freight. This one is going quite slow, as I would hear the rumble or the engine of this train. The only thing that you guys, we would hear here at Kearney's Crossing would either the engine or the roar of the engine of this train, or any type of train. They would sneak up on us, so this one would not sneak up on us because we would hear this one from miles away. Trash train 63D would hit go to Mango Junction in Ohio, just by the border of Pennsylvania and Ohio. Man, this train stinks. As I was recording this train, it stinks so bad that we still must smell this for like miles away, even as it went by already.
Yeah.
go, another westbound. This one will be an intermodal with an ace leader, a C6M. No, that's a dash 9. Dash 9 will be trailing. So yeah. This one I snuck, well, I was riding my scooter, and I saw it when it was about to go around the corner. Saw a headlight, and I said to myself, gotta get ready. So here we are now. Could the end go by sooner? We would have gotten this eastbound if the westbound would have gone a little quicker. Oh well, we would still see a train. Not as long as I thought it would. Many times. He snuck up. As soon as I heard the horn while the westbound was going by, I was like, oh no! Anyway, we would still see many more. Here we go. Here comes another train. Unfortunately, this will be the helper set. Why do we have these helper sets? But it counts as seen trains. But I look back. Here comes a coal train. Looks like to be meeting the helper set. A double A will be leading the coal train for Shire Oak, Pennsylvania. Wow, it's been very busy. Even though I've been here for like 2 hours at Carty's Crossing, there it goes, another helper set bound for Crescent. And now here comes another westbound, which is an intermodal with two GEs. But this will still count for more trains. Even though we saw like a lot of now, so yeah, it'll still continue as for the evening or night. I'm not gonna stay here till night. I'm gonna go to the hotel and then maybe do whatever I want. Maybe the Brickyard's walking, which will be in a little few hours. Well, here comes another westbound. This one ain't going as fast as the intermodals and coal trains were. It's a solo engine, which is leading in ethanol. An ethanol train is coming from somewhere in New Jersey or Pennsylvania towards Chicago and Illinois. But the power would end up being switched in Conway, Pennsylvania. This is a solo AC44C6M 4340 with solo leads of ethanol. Well, here comes another ethanol. A solo ET44AH or AC would be leading this ethanol. So it would be ending up a solo GE that would be leading. But yeah, another one. But this one is actually going track speed as the other one did not. Which is I'm shocked. The other ethanol that went by, the first one, was not going track speed, but this one is actually going track speed. Very odd. Wow, that was a surprise. As soon as the helper set went by, I would have probably got it where my tripod is at. But I went to the other side of the crossing. Well, not to the other side where it's backlit, but the same side where it's like completely lit at. Just GE's, who cares? It's Pennsylvania. I don't really care. I don't go to Pennsylvania much, so it doesn't really matter to me. But it reminds me of this intermodal that's going by. We would probably see more intermodals than we would today. a double helper set. Two helper sets went east, bound for Crescent or Altoona, Pennsylvania. But here comes Amtrak 43, the Pennsylvanian. We'll be heading for Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Would just have a normal P-42-118 would just be leading it. Amtrak does fly in Pennsylvania on the Pittsburgh line. Coney's Crossing and the Brickyard Crossing would not be the only crossings in Pennsylvania that the Pittsburgh line gets on the NS Allegheny. But here comes another train. It's come to the evening. No sun now. We will be completely backlit with the NS eastbound manifest that will go to Enola, Pennsylvania. So, yeah, now it's like completely about to get dark soon. I don't usually wilt in at night anymore. I just think that's just overrated, and like, I don't like to blind the crews anymore. But tonight, however, I kinda did, because we would only wilt in at the Brickyard Crossing, because I've never been here before. And I may as well try this spot out. But looks like there's another train. This one is a westbound, bound for Chicago. It's an intermodal, so he would be, well, I thought he would be going track speed, but he is not. Just a bunch of GEs that's leading the train, which I do not care, but oh well, what are you going to get in the Pittsburgh line? I thought there would be Heritage units on day one, but I guess not. Let's just get the westbound. Our next train, besides this one's going by still, maybe not now, here comes a local that came from Altoona, Woe Yard. I don't know where this one's going, but he's still going west out of Altoona with the triple Jeep. Just a bunch of cars, not much. But until the morning, I'll be at the Horseshoe Curve. Good morning. We have made it to the Horseshoe Curve, Pennsylvania. Well, we were going to get the Pennsylvanian 42 at Glenson, but someone had to make a wise story that it would go onto the other tracks, not the double. So I missed the Amtrak this morning. Oh well, what are you going to do? I can't blame him. He checked the Amtrak tracker, he thought it was going to be on the single. But I guess not. It comes a eastbound manifest with an UP Thundercab. I think it's a Thundercab that's trailing second on a manifest. Here comes a loaded coal train, two engines in front, I don't know if it will have two in the middle. Yeah, I don't know about that. Well, you're just gonna have to wait and see. It's a loaded coal train, so it probably will. Or that it'll have helpers at the rear of this train. But you never know. What I seen, this coal train had a rear and middle DPU. So that means that this is a pretty heavy train to go through Pennsylvania. Here comes another eastbound. We would have a stack train that would head towards New Jersey or Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, with just two GEs. One is a Gevo and it's a Dash 9 that's trailing second. So we don't have that much Dash 9s anymore as we used to, but they're all just being rebuilded into AC44C6Ms. But that's okay, I guess. You can't do anything. It's the will, or they can rebuild the Monkalotus if they want to, as they're doing right now. They're almost nearing to the 47 series of them. So it's starting to get pretty boring. Let's get this Animortal going by the Hoichi curve. Here comes 63B, that is a trash train. I don't know where this one came from, but it goes to Mango Junction in Ohio. We didn't smell the stink this time because it wasn't as bad as yesterday. So I don't know if it wasn't that it was loaded. It pretty much was loaded, but it wasn't smelling as bad as yesterday was. So I don't know. I don't know if they have them all loaded in. I don't know. This is the second one I've seen this trip. We wouldn't see one again for a little while. So, let's just get the trash train. Thank you. Here comes a stack tray. Had to brighten it up a little bit because it was pretty dark on a camera. So, with a little bit of editing skills, I could do brightening up just like this. But now, it's like pretty lighting up that it's like you can see the tray now, like right now. Because it has gotten a little bit dark because it's storming at the force you curve. So, I don't know. It's just pretty weird. It was a 50% chance, so I guess we got the rain now. Cool, it's all off. It was pretty hot. So, yeah. The SAG train is heading towards Chicago and Illinois. So, the SAG train's going by the curve with the horn show. I don't know what the NS crews think they're getting horn shows with it, but at the curve with the well fans at the curve. Here comes another train. This one's another stack train for Chicago and Illinois. But this one has something kind of cool on it. It has a Wells Fargo unit, one of the ex-BNSF units. And it's starting leasing these ex-BNSF Wells Fargo units since May of 2023. And ever since that, I've been seeing a lot of these on the Chicago line, including this one.
going. It's starting to pick up pretty good. I know, dude. I can't help it with that. Come on. Yeah.
Stay in here, boy.
Sure.
Well, that was an awfully surprise. Well, actually, I heard it from my friend. He was watching the Crescent camera while I was at the curb. Luckily, there's service at the curb now, so we can contact each other, what's going by Crescent and what's not. He was always checking ATCS in Altoona, Pennsylvania, while I'm at the curb. He was telling me if there's a westbound coming. With a 70M-2, 2765 would take the lead of the brand new paint of the Burimax unit. Well, here comes another eastbound. Well, this one has an ACU leading on this ethanol, but another supplies have came. another Wells Fargo unit that is trailing on this ethanol. My friend told me this. Didn't know when it was supposed to arrive. Now it arrived. Now it's going by the curve. And it's empty. Well, might be loaded. I don't know. I think they empty this stuff. Well, I take that back. They might actually be loaded. Bound for Wiley Bold, Delaware. So, I don't know if they just take it west when it's empty, and then east when it's loaded. Not sure. I'm pretty sure they take it east when it's loaded.
Thank you.
Well, sunshine has came up. There's no more storms. No more cloudiness. But we would have a westbound and an eastbound will ending up showing up soon. But our first one would be a westbound that would end up showing up first. It's a manifest, so we have not seen a lot of manifests. The only thing that we have seen is intermortals. I know this is kind of like backlit, but I can't do anything about it. We're still at the curve as of right now. They close at 5 p.m. They actually kick you out at 5 p.m., so you actually have to leave at 5 p.m. Just a GE that's leading, GEVO, and then a Dash 9 that's trailing on this manifest. It will end up having helpers, but I would get blocked by the eastbound in a few minutes. This would be the ethanol or the train that I would be talking about earlier. So now I would get blocked due to the helper set, but that doesn't really matter. It's just normal ACUs, whatever. But to me, however, there's not that many ACUs in the NS roster anymore. All of them are either still in freight service, which not that many, and some of them, a lot of them, are either on helper set, which is in Crescent or Altoona. They usually keep the helper sets there. So they do a lot of that 24/7. So yeah. It's a lot of helper sets, and plus they take up a lot of crews in Pennsylvania too. Yeah. Now we're in Glenson, Pennsylvania, after we moved from the curve to Glenson Tunnel. We would have our first train at Glenson. We would end up seeing at the curve when we left. So it just had two AC-44Cs at Sam, but it's an intermodal going for Chicago and Illinois. However, we would only see three trains. Two of them are intermodal. Well, actually, five, because we would actually see the tail end of both of them. One of them was intermodal. One of them was an eastbound X-way on this double track. Somehow, some trains go underneath the Clemson Tunnel here on the double track. They should go on the single, which is... Somehow, they always go with the eastbound, with the flow, but sometimes they want it through with the tunnel. So, yeah. This one is just westbound, so every westbound will go through the Glenson Tunnel.
Wow. It's gonna be busy.
Probably that train that I saw earlier is probably heading towards Horseshoe Curve pretty soon.
Fucking hell.
I don't know. I didn't see it. But I saw the DPU.
Way ahead of DPU.
Yep.
We would actually have one more intermodal before the Amtrak Pennsylvanian heading towards Pittsburgh. Just has a normal P-42, I'm guessing. Well, actually it does have a normal P-42. This crew on this intermodal would give us a horn show, which is pretty cool. So, yeah. So, intermodals, all westbound, like I said earlier, would go through here. Same thing with Amtrak. Amtrak eastbound 42 Pennsylvanian would also go through here. Not the single, which is what I thought would be would go on the single, but it does not.
Nice and slow.
Comes
the rain.
Yeah,
it's
over.
Yeah.
Well, here comes another westbound on the Pittsburgh. This will be our final train of the day before going back to the hotel. If you guess it, this is Amtrak 43, the Pennsylvanian, as I talked about earlier in the two last trains. Here we go, Amtrak heads to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, but this will be the final spot of the day. But until next time, I'll see you guys in the Kansadia Overlook in Pennsylvania. Good morning in Kansadia Overlook. This is our new spot. I've never been here in Kansadia. It's all three tracks. I missed the Pennsylvania 42 again. Just barely like a minute. But here comes a westbound that is going fast. They fly through here. This is the only first train, full train I have captured here. I got the weird GPU of the manifest that we caught when we got here. There goes a little something special that we've seen at Kansadia. A solo ace being led with a work train. I don't know if this is considered a work train or not, but it's cool. I'm guessing there's probably a lot of work on the track. This is triple track. From Pittsburgh to like out east of Harrisburg. Here comes a manifest. I would see it from the horseshoe curve camera because it's live still, always live. And I seen this one coming from the cam, and I would figure it would take like 30 to 40 minutes long. This one only took 30 minutes from Horseshoe Curve to here in Kansadia. All right. Think you can tell where this spot's at? This one is Portage, Pennsylvania. Here, our first train will be a westbound in NS mixed weight, bound for Conway, Pennsylvania, with another Wells Fargo unit that is trailing ticket. We would have a main ECU and some helper sets being on the rear of this manifest that will be helping. This train's going quite track speed in Portage. This will be our final train at Portage and for the trip as well. I would see more, but I wouldn't be like filming it on the camera. Neither as taking pictures. I would just look at them. So it would have a sister AC-44 CQ-7, 46 series, 4639, and 4638. Those are sisters of brand new rebuild that will be leading this intermodal bound for Harrisburg. This gladly decision of making my way to Pennsylvania on the first day, now we're on a final day. We have to go back home to Toledo, Wales. Fortunately, today's video, we'll be signing off here in Portage, Pennsylvania. I'll be either seeing you, Michiganer, or Buckeye State Wales.